In the 2 years as the Aggie back, Preston Jackson shattered every Cal Aggie rushing record. Jackson, determined to show everyone that 1992 was only the beginning, started off 1993 with a bang as he ran for his 11th consecutive 100-yard game against Cal Poly in the season opener. His streak of 100-yard games would hit 12. He rushed for over 100 yards in 21 out of 23 starts. His bruising style powered him into the end zone 24 times this season. His ability to follow his blockers to daylight made him a threat to score anytime, anywhere, as was evidenced by his 78-yard touchdown scamper on a fourth and short play against Chico State. The second-team All-American back was named Sports Illustrated Small College Player of the Week. He was also named Conference Player of the Week twice during the 93 campaign. Jackson finished the season with 1,826 yards rushing for 3,325 yards on his career. He scored 142 points this season, upping his career mark to 246 points. All these totals place him number one in the Aggie record books from the line of scrimmage. The big back proved that 92 was just the tip of the iceberg. Opposing defensive coordinators check themselves into padded rooms after having been subjected to the wizardry of Aggie quarterback Kahari Jones. Kahari's 1993 performance was worthy of an Oscar. It is now the Aggies who will have to try and find someone to play Kahari's role next season and beyond. The honorable mention All-American was named the American West Conference's inaugural Offensive Player of the Year. Coach Biggs and Kahari were able to set the stage for the high-powered Aggie offense that averaged over 38 points a game. Kahari's feel for the game brought out the best in those around him. The pressure of being the Aggie signal caller rolled off Gahari like a bootleg. He threw for over 300 yards four times this season on his way to 3,174 yards passing. This season, Gahari found his receivers streaking into the end zone 29 times. He smashed NFL quarterback Ken O'Brien's career touchdown passing mark as he finished with 50 touchdown passes. He holds the career total offense, single season total offense, and single season passing marks also. The amazing thing to remember is that Gahari accomplished all this in only two seasons. Of the Aggies in 1993 was a true champion. All-conference slot-back receiver Mike Ichiyama was Kahari's primary target in 1993. Ichi caught 57 passes this past season. He darted into the end zone five times through the air and four times on the ground. Ichi was a gamer as he constantly bemused and befuddled defenders. If Gahari was a wizard, then Ichi was the magician. His sideline acrobatic tightrope run against Northridge had to be seen to be believed. His versatility will be welcomed back in 1994. Wide receiver Arnold Hardy and Gahari had a long-distance relationship. Hardy proved to be a real sprint as he scored seven touchdowns on 31 receptions, averaging 23 yards per catch. Hardy was also able to give the Aggies excellent field position with his explosive kickoff return. Mario McCarthy had four touchdowns as he and Mark Eddy, Steve Hubbell, Fred Higginson, and Cameron Smythe rounded out a talented group of wideouts.
Yeah.
was also able to utilize running backs Rusty Styrers and Tyler Moore to give the passing game a totally different dimension.
Dance ain't for everybody, only the sexy people. So all you fly mothers, get on out there and dance. Dance, I said.
Big play all-conference tight end Aaron Bennett will be back to terrorize defenses in 1994. All he did in 1993 was catch 41 passes for 7 touchdowns. His leaping touchdown grab against Northridge helped spark the Aggie victory. Evan Gordon and Graham Brown were integral parts of the Aggie 2 tight end attack. Of the 1993 offense was how everyone complemented each other. Each group made each other better. The foundation for this was the offensive line. Never before had the Aggies lined up a group so strong, so powerful, and so talented. Led by honorable mention All-American center Bob Schultz, this group had an in-your-face attitude. Guards Brett Korda and Matt Ekman, tackle Jeff Brooks and Greg Ames, and swingman Jay Brooks helped the Aggies to average over 510 yards per game in total offense. Because of these men up front, Coach Biggs was willing to roll the dice more often than not.
Just go ahead now, and if you like to tell that maybe, just go ahead now, and if you wanna buy me flowers, just go ahead now.
The special teams were led by the hard-hitting Lenny Tran. Tran's fearless play, coupled with the dog determination of Graham Brown, Lance Casaza, Tim Allen, Brian Smith, Visco Ancich, Lonnie Lewis, Dave McDivitt, Bryce Elliott, Matt Lee, and Evan Gordon helped this unit make key plays. Rafael Fernandez ended his career as an Aggie as the number 2 all-time field goal kicker and the all-time PAT leader.
That's what I said now, princess, princess who adore you. Just go ahead now, one last diamond in his pocket. And that's a friend now, this one, who wants to buy you rockets. And it is him now, marry him, or marry me. I'm the one to look at, but can't you see? I ain't got no bitch up in the tree, but I know what a prince and lover ought to be. I know what a prince and lover ought to be. Said if you want to call me baby, just go ahead now. And if you like to tell me maybe, just go ahead now. And if you wonder about just go ahead now. And if you want to call that baby, just go ahead now. And if you like to tell that lady, just go ahead now. And if you like to buy that flower, just go ahead now. And if you like to talk for hours, just go ahead now. If you want to call that lady, just go ahead now.
Time and again, they were able to come up with a big play at a crucial moment. Led by Darrell Foster, who had 5 interceptions, Sean Parker, Bobby Bluford, Ralph Colbert, and Danny Marenko, these cornerbacks flirted with danger and never blinked. Strong safety Andy Stoddard was the team's second leading tackler. He was especially effective against St. Mary's, helping the defense in their second half surge to victory. Safeties Matt Miklojewski and Jeff Krieger call the shots from center field. Defensive line was anchored by senior defensive end Scott Fuller. Fuller led the team in quarterback sacks. He was the rock on the defensive line as he was named All-Conference. After senior captain Keith Dunn went down with an injury, Amari Patterson stepped up with solid play. Lance Casaza, Jason Dillard, and Calvin Young rounded out the flank. Senior tackle Tyler Moore helped plug the middle along with junior Eric Leekes. Mike Johnson showed that he has the tools to be a force next season. Fighting through injuries. Thank you. playoff drive began with the Aggies needing to clinch the conference championship against Sacramento State. The Hornets were no match as Jackson set the single-game rushing record by gaining 243 yards and two touchdowns. Kahari passed for three touchdowns as the Aggies gained 567 total yards on offense. Defensively, the Aggies forced the Hornets to switch quarterbacks trying to find the right combination. Mikolajewski and Foster had key interceptions. Finding themselves trailing 28-9, the Aggies willed themselves a stirring 37-34 victory against Fort Hays in the opening round of the Division II playoffs. Jackson scored 26 points, breaking the school's single-game scoring record held since 1925. Kahari's leadership was never more evident as he completed a key fourth-down play in the waning moments of the fourth quarter. His big offensive line gave him the time to throw as he never waiting for Ichiyama to break free. The defense atoned for itself with a furious play in the fourth quarter. Mike Johnson, Ray Willis, and Sean Parker had big plays to seal the victory. Fortunately for the Aggies, the red-hot Javelinas of Texas A&M, Kingsville, were the next playoff opponent. Forcing the Aggies into uncharacteristic turnovers, Texas A&M staked an early lead. The Aggies were game, though, as they roared back with 2 second quarter scores to cut the gap. It wasn't enough, though. The Aggies fought and clawed their way throughout the game against a team that eventually would be a 2-point conversion short of a possible national title. Coach Biggs' first season as head football coach was truly a memorable one. The Aggies were a point short of having an undefeated regular season. They made the playoffs for the 11th time in 16 seasons. They are still the only non-scholarship team to compete in the postseason. The Aggies set or tied 38 records this season en route to a 10-2 record. They placed first in a Division I AA conference. Preston Jackson and Bob Schultz played in the Division II Shrine Game, and Coach Biggs was named Kodak Region 5 Coach of the Year. The senior leadership that led the Aggies to these lofty heights will be sorely missed. But, as always, it will be Aggie pride that will carry the Aggies on to their new, exciting challenge of competing as an independent in 1994.
Help their fellow man. Love your country and live with pride. And don't forget those who died. America, can't you see? All gave some. Some gave all, and some stood through for the red, white, and blue, and some had to fall. And if you ever gave all, some gave all.
had just lost his pay. What did he do it for? It never made it through our door. He drank the weed away. And what can a family say? There must be a better way. Now, mama, don't start to cry. Let's give him love a try. Pick up the telephone. Tell him you want him home. To sit and watch the evenings pass and read in the leaves of grass. I'm caught in a closing door. It's pinning me to the floor. Now, mama, don't start to cry. Let's give him love a try. Do-do-da-da-da-da.